Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Flavor Kingdom Kitchen. Today guys, I'm going to be making for you braised short ribs. If you are new to my channel, please do not leave without subscribing and liking this video and leave a comment so that I know that you was here. If you are not new to my channel, please feel welcome guys. You are welcome anytime. So guys, today I have in front of me the short ribs. I already washed and pat dry with paper towel, and now I'm going to lightly season them. And the mixture that I'm using, I'm going to be putting in the description box. So if you guys want this recipe, be sure to check out my description box. Also, I'm going to put my link in there to my Instagram so that you guys could DM me any questions you have. So as you guys can see, I'm sprinkling this with my seasoning lightly, guys. After, we're gonna go ahead and sear these off in a pan. You have to make sure that your pan is hot before placing your short ribs in there, because you don't want them to stick to that pan. So you make sure that they're hot, and then you carefully place them in there, because you know we're working with oil and we don't want to get burned. So you want to make sure that you carefully do so. Please do not drop them and run. Okay guys, so gently place them in there. After we've placed them all in there, we're gonna go ahead and place my garlic in there. So I used the whole thing of garlic and I just sliced it in half, as you guys could see, and then placed them face down in there. And then I'm going to add some aromatics, which is my thyme, to give it that nice flavor. After like a minute and a half, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and flip them to sear the other side. Just allow it to go, guys, for like a minute and a half, and it gives you beautiful caramelized color. Okay guys, so after we finish searing these, we're gonna directly put them into a pan that is suitable for the oven, because we're going to be braising these now, and we're going to be braising them in the oven. So basically I'm gonna just place them directly in the pan. You don't have to spray it, you don't have to line it, nothing. You just place the short ribs in the pan along with your garlic and your thyme. Then we're gonna go ahead and pour our red wine over them. When you're braising, you go 3/4 up the meat, so you don't wanna completely cover, so just 3/4 up. But we're going to also be adding some beef stock into this. So then we're gonna do half beef stock and half red wine. Don't fully cover your short ribs, just halfway up them. And then we're gonna add some tomato paste into this to help with the coloration. After you have done this, guys, we're gonna go ahead and place this in the oven for 2.5 hours on 200 degrees Fahrenheit. So guys, while this is in the oven, you can do whatever you want. Just let them slow cook and they will be so tender, I promise. Okay guys, so while that's in the oven, we're gonna go ahead and work on the topping. This is my pancetta and we're gonna go ahead and slice it. Okay guys, so here I have it. It's already done slicing. So what we're gonna do, we're going to place this in the pan. You can start off with a cold pan. Remember, we're rendering this. So you start off in a cold pan so that it will be crispy from the residual heat that it's going to get. So we're gonna place this in the pan now and allow it to render down. Okay guys, so we're gonna chop up some mushrooms to add into that. I've just washed them and I'm drying them sort of. So we're gonna just slice these roughly. So guys, this is now rendered down. So we're gonna go ahead and add in our mushrooms. So the reason why I use the pancetta, guys, is because, you know, mushroom has no taste. So it takes on the flavor of whatever you put it with. So we want it to kind of absorb the saltiness to kind of balance off the sweetness that we're going to get from the braised short ribs in the red wine sauce. So I did that so that everything will just balance, have a balanced harmony to it. I'm just sprinkling some black pepper in this, guys. No salt, because remember, pancetta is already salty. So you don't want any salt in this. And we're just tossing this around until it's like absorb. As you guys could see here, we're gonna let it go for a little bit more. And then we're gonna check on our short ribs. Okay guys, it's been 2.5 hours and our short ribs are ready, guys. Look at them, they look so juicy and they are so tender. So now we're gonna go ahead and strain the sauce. This is gonna be our sauce, guys. So we're gonna strain it and then we're going to reduce it, put it on the flame and let it boil, basically until it thickens. So as you guys can see, I'm straining it out. And then we're letting it reduce, guys. Alrighty guys, so that's it for this video. I'm going to be plating the food now for you guys. I made some mashed potatoes to go with this and I'm just going to just plate it to show you guys how I plate. So you guys always tell me you like how my food look attractive when it's plated and everything. So for a little tip for you guys, when you're plating, the only thing you have to think about is height, color, and the texture of the food that you're working with. You have to make sure that everything goes together. So as you guys could see, I always think about two as well. That's the number I always use. So as you guys could see, I'm just plating it for you guys. I stacked them to achieve my height and I use two short ribs, and then I'm going to go ahead and top that with the mushroom and the pancetta. I'm just gonna eat that one. Okay guys, so remember I said you have to think about color, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this parsley to achieve the color aspect. Then I'm gonna go ahead now and also add some more color to this. So I have some julienne carrots and I'm going to also add that on there to give it a bit more of a color pop. Green always goes well with orange, I feel. I'm gonna add that on there. But look at this plate, guys. Oh my god, it looks so good. So guys, remember to like this video, remember to comment, let me know you was here. Check me out on Instagram, where you guys are free to DM me. And as always, thank you guys for watching.